Okay. Okay, this is the first stage of design process. Okay, define problem, gather information, concept generation, and evaluation of concept. Okay, so for the first phase, that the thing that we are doing now is define problem and gather information. As I mentioned to you previously, once you have once you already finalize the project, so you have to find information from catalog, okay, would like to get the specification, technical specification of the similar products, of the nearest products to the product that you want to design. And then you also have to gather information from YouTube so that you will understand how the machine works. And you have to also refer to pattern to study on the mechanisms that each machine use to not to perform certain function. So you have to refer to these three types of sources so that you can come up with the ideas on what are the concept or what are the mechanism that you are going to use in your machine. So for the next stage, I already explained to you also about the about the construction of questionnaire. Important of questionnaire is because for the first stage, get the information stage, it's all about you to design. So the next stage, you have to get information from your targeted users. Okay, as I mentioned to you before, if your product is a home use product or is product mass production, so you have to get or you have to ask to wider group of respondent. But if your machine is more for the industrial use, for example, for specific industries, so you have to you have to construct questionnaire, and then you have to construct question, and then you just interview or just ask the specific industries. You do not have to, so you don't have to ask a lot of industries. It's just enough. For example, if you ask one or two industries that related to the machine that you want to produce. Okay, from the questionnaire, you will get the importance requirement. What are the importance requirements? What are the importance objective for your product lah? Okay. Generally, when we talk about requirement, we have, for example, we have function. Okay, functional requirement, design requirement, we have safety requirement, and then we have ergonomics requirement. We have energy requirement. We have several types of requirements. So that's those requirements you must get from the targeted users. Okay. So based on your study, based on your market survey, you should get the top 5 requirements that being required by your potential users. So based on that requirement, then you have to construct your objective 3. Objective 3, after that, you will use the objective 3 and the result that you obtain from the questionnaire to construct the weightage of the objective 3. Okay. So after that, you have to proceed with QFD. I think last week, I already explained to you a bit on what is now QFD. Okay. Okay. I already explained about objective 3 and the weightage of objective 3. So the next stage, we are going to proceed for QFD. I think I already told you about QFD. QFD is called function deployment. The purpose of QFD is to convert a customer requirement into technical requirement. Because the language that being used by engineers or designers is not the same as what being used by customers. So we have to convert all the customers' requirement into technical requirement. I already told you last week, the customers will require a machine that easy to use. For example, easy to use, cheap in price, safe to use, and then environmental friendly, require less or no maintenance. If during maintenance, the maintenance might require only low cost or no cheap spare part. So all those user requirement must be converted into technical requirement, or these, you know, all these technical requirement. Okay, I already explained to you how you can convert the user requirement to technical requirement. So today I will directly show you how can you convert the user requirement to technical requirement. Okay, before that, I just want you have to be familiar with the QFD. Okay, if I ask you to draw a QFD, okay, you have to know how to draw this QFD. This is the format of QFD. Eh? This is a format of QFD. The first, actually it consists of 8 rooms, we call as rooms, and one roof, 7 room and one roof. Okay, the first room, this is the first room. Okay, this one is customer requirement. Okay, customer requirement. So from where you should take this customer requirement? Huh? From where should you take this customer requirement?
From questionnaire.
Okay, questionnaire. Questionnaire, I think last week, where is the questionnaire? Wait, eh? Yeah, my questionnaire. Okay, for example, this is your questionnaire. Okay, and you already have 5 top requirement that being asked by your customers. Okay, contohnya, this is the top 5 lah. Function, maintenance, design, safety, ergonomic, and price. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 5. Okay, the 5th one, for example, this one, sustainable. Okay, as I mentioned to you, you should select top 5 best requirement that been required by customers. But then you should include the sustainable or environmental requirement. Ini wajib, eh? Regardless of either your customers really need the sustainable or the environmental punya environmental punya requirement. Okay, kalau dia tak nak, sila bawa kena masukkan sustainable punya requirement as now the soft skill that I'm going to evaluate you is sustainable lah environment. So awak kena masukkan lah. Okay, katakan awak ada 5 ni, awak just copy from the questionnaire yang awak dapat tu. Awak pergi ke KFD awak. Okay, for example, this is your KFD. Jadi awak copy di sini, eh. Ya. Okay, we have 12 requirement. Okay, jadi kita tambah sini. Okay, jadi ni awak masukkan yang awak dah tu tadi, eh. Okay, easy to use and so on lah ni. Sampai bawah tu, eh. Okay, jadi these are the requirements that being required by your customers when you do the questionnaire lah. Jadi awak ambil questionnaire tu, awak copy je masuk dalam customer requirement ni, eh. Tapi awak kena ni sikit lah, eh. Contohnya function ni. Okay, this function and maintenance, we have 3 requirements under maintenance, 1 under design, 3 under safety, and 3 under sustainable. Okay, jadi awak Nih ya, jadi for function. Okay, cara macam mana tu tak kisahlah. Janji awak masuk kat sini ni saya tunjuk kalau awak pakai copy paste ni. Tapi kalau nak type satu-satu balik pun tak ada masalah. Jadi kat sini ni, this is the first requirement function. Jadi untuk mudahkan awak, awak clusterkan dia. For example, this one A is function. Okay, function. Okay, this one easy to move. Easy to move. Okay, lepas tu awak under maintenance sini eh. Jadi maintenance, awak masuk maintenance. Okay, sini B. B maintenance. Okay, maintenance, we have easy to maintain, low maintenance cost, low frequency of maintenance. Okay, this one design, design C. Okay, C. Tadi apa? Attractive eh? Attractive design. Okay, lepas tu ada safety. Okay, and then awak ada sustainable. Sustainable requirement. Okay, when do ada sustainable, we have three elements under sustainable. We have social, economy and environment. Tapi basically most of the time when we talk about sustainable, okay, it almost refer to, mostly refer to environment. Okay, safety D, and then sustainable E, D. Okay, jadi yang satu ni awak ni numbering balik kan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 eh. Okay, jadi awak ambil daripada apa yang awak dah dapat daripada questionnaire tu, dan awak masuk dah bawah customer requirement. Okay, ada soalan sampai sini? Sampai sini ada soalan?
Ya, doktor.
Okay eh. Okay, lepas tu dekat sini juga, the second one is important weightage. Important weightage awak ambil daripada mana? Important weightage.
Objective 3.
Objective 3 punya weightage eh. Awak ambil daripada objective 3 punya weightage. Jadi awak dah ada weightage, contoh ni ada weightage awak yang awak dah buat eh. Jadi awak ambil, awak ambil value yang ni je, yang number je, sorry, yang number je. Awak dapat weightage dekat objective 3 punya weightage. Jadi awak tengok yang ni punya weightage, and then awak masukkan dia punya weightage. Okay, kalau awak ada lah kosong-kosong, ambil yang bawah ni, yang biru, yang kuning-kuning je awak ambil. Okay, sepatutnya bila awak campur yang kuning-kuning ni, okay, contoh dekat sini awak 0.05, okay, yang ni ada 0.01 contohnya, 0.15, 0.1, ni terlebih satu, ni terlebih satu, 0.1, 0.1, 0.15.
Dekat E 0.05 tu tak ada sustainable.
Apa dia?
Sustainable E.
Oh, terlajak. Okay, jadi awak sepatutnya awak ambil daripada related relative weightage yang awak dah buat tadi. Okay, awak ambil yang value-value yang ada dalam QFD awak yang kuning, yang numbers eh. Yang ni dia punya main requirement, Okay, dalam questionnaire awak, awak dah tanya the insufficient, easy to move ke, okay, easy to maintain ke. Okay, awak dah tanya eh. Jadi awak ambil tu, awak masukkan je kat sini eh. Easy to move. Okay. Jadi awak ambil kat sini, sepatutnya kalau awak isi betul, dia punya value sama dengan 1 eh. Okay. Lepas tu last week juga saya dah tunjuk awak, saya dah terang awak macam mana awak nak convert customer requirement kepada technical requirement. Okay. Jadi secara asasnya kriteria to convert user requirement into technical requirement satu, dia mesti measurable. Okay, measurable ataupun countable lah, boleh dikira eh. Dia boleh dikira eh. Contohnya apa? Contohnya kalau user requirementnya easy to use. Okay. Technical requirementnya apa?
Portability.
Ha?
Dimension.
Dimension.
Awak ambil dimension tu spesifik tau. Awak jangan kata dimension. Dimension awak tak dimension. Dimension boleh kira kan? Dimension. Atau awak kena letak lah dimension biasa di unit. Okay, for example, meter kali. Meter contohnya. Maknanya kalau dia kecil, mudahlah awak guna lagi. Weight. Kilogram. Okay, maknanya ni adalah easy to use, dimension, weight. Kalau dia nak low in price. Awak punya user requirement awak low in price. Dia punya technical requirement apa?
Material
saya dah beritahu minggu lepas. Material ni kita tak masuk kan? Material kita masuk kan? Pasal dalam produk awak ni dia ada pelbagai material. Kecuali kalau awak punya produk tu, contohnya awak jual bumper kereta. Bumper kereta tu semua satu material je, sama ada awak pakai fiber ke, awak pakai ABS ke, awak pakai PP ke, ada satu material, okey. Tapi kalau produk tu dia punya body dia mungkin PP. Dalam dia tu dah ada food grade punya stainless steel contohnya. Ada pelbagai. Jadi material awak tak masukkan. Jadi apa? Low price straightforward je. Yang boleh kira apa? Kalau saya nak produk saya nak produk yang murah. Price. Okay, low in price. Okay, lagi. Contohnya dia nak produk yang environmental friendly. Mesra alam sekitar. Okay. Technical requirement apa? Technical requirement untuk environmental friendly. Saya nak produk saya tu dia baik untuk alam sekitar.
Material.
Yeah, boleh? Tak dengar tak kira ya?
Bahan yang digunakan.
Jangan. Dia kena ada value tau kalau ni. Measurable atau countable? Bahan digunakan boleh measure?
Boleh.
Measure per label, measure. Power consumption. Lagi banyak power ni tu. Apa? Macam mana power consumption boleh relate to environmental friendly?
Dia pakai apa ni tenaga semula jadi. Macam contohnya kalau kita pakai solar apa? Pakai solar ke? Pakai biomass ke? Itu contoh.
Itu jenis. two type of power ataupun type of power source. Okay, type of power source. Tapi dia dia ada itulah jenis kan. Ni power consumption ni. Macam mana power consumption?
Dia
macam
kira
power consumption relate to environmental friendly.
Kira berapa banyak power diperlukan untuk produce that product lah, doktor.
Oh, yang energy rating, doktor. Energy rating.
Bintang
berapa bintang.
Jadi awak pun tahu, saya ingat awak, you as a mechanical engineer, awak perlu tahu kaitan antara apa yang awak buat dengan alam sekitar. Okay, yang paling directnya adalah power lah. Power awak buat, awak lampu eh. Lampu dia 30 watt. Lampu 30 watt dengan compare dengan LED, for example LED 15 watt. Kan beza kan? Maknanya lampu setiap kali kita gunakan lampu, every time you want to use electricity, the power plant tu have to generate electricity dulu, generate power. Dekat Malaysia pula, dekat Malaysia apa material yang digunakan untuk generate power?
Terbaik.
Arang.
Hidro, alang.
Main dia pakai apa tu, minyak, arang, coal. Arang kan? Coal. Ada yang pakai minyak untuk bakar, untuk pan. Jadi semua tu dibakar, dia akan menghasilkan carbon dioxide. Jadi that's why power consumption tu, dia relate to environmental friendly. Apa tu noise? Environmental friendly ni not only directly, kalau dia mengganggu awak punya ni pendengaran, dia pun itulah satu indikator untuk environment juga, noise. Okay, jadi power consumption, noise. Jadi awak tengok ni adalah countable, measurable. Okay, yang ketiga Dia ada value lah. Contohnya awak kata ni, awak kata type of power source, type of material. Okay, dia ada value lah. Okay, value dia, power source dia bukan nilai, dia ada specific item tu. Okay, kalau power source awak pakai elektrik ke, awak pakai gasoline ke, type material awak pakai PP ke, ABS ke. Okay. Yang keempat lah dari segi availability. Availability, contohnya safety features. Safety features ada ke tak ada? Okay, safety features ada tak ada? Cap. Ada ke tak ada? Okay, ini yang cara awak nak convert user requirement kepada technical requirement. Okay, technical requirement di bahagian atas ni. Di bahagian atas ni semuanya adalah technical requirement. Okay. Dan saya dah beritahu awak sebelum ni, kalau awak nak convert satu-satu ni, dia akan jadi lambat. Jadi apa yang perlu awak buat, pasal technical requirement ni awak dah ada sebelum ni tau. Sebagai daripada technical requirement ni awak dah ada. Daripada mana? Daripada mana awak dah ada tu? Apa dia technical requirement tu?
Catalog?
Bukan. Jangan jauh sangat.
Specification.
Daripada mana? Awak dah buat sebelum ni? Cuba ingat balik apa proses awak yang awak dah buat sebelum ni dan dia mengandungi technical specification.
Oh, pattern.
Apa?
Pattern lah.
Tak clear?
Pattern.
Macam apa?
Benchmark.
Pattern. Benchmark. Awak dapat benchmark sebelum ni. Jadi kalau tengok benchmark awak, mana benchmark? Benchmark ni. Contoh awak ada benchmark ni. Production capacity, mechanical speed, power absorption semua ni. Awak copy semua ni. Awak copy semua ni, awak pergi ke awak punya KFD tadi. Ni KFD awak ni. Awak pergi ke atas ni, awak copy paste special values transpose. Transpose ni kalau awak nak terbalik kan tau, awak copy dari atas ke bawah. Tapi awak nak paste, awak nak dia paste kiri ke kanan. Jadi awak boleh pakai function transpose ni. Okay. Tapi sebab saya merge ni tak boleh lah. Okay, merge ni saya kena unmerge dulu. Okay, contohnya saya unmerge dulu yang ni. Saya buat yang baru lah eh. Ini awak dah buat, awak dah ambil. Okay. Okay, jadi next kita nak dekat technical requirement pula eh. Technical requirement awak dah ambil daripada benchmarking tadi. Awak dah ada dalam benchmarking. Jadi benchmarking ni awak copy dia punya item-item ni eh, specification ni. Awak pergi QFD awak yang belah atas ni. Belah atas ni eh. Awak copy paste special values transpose. Okay, jadi dia akan susun. Dia akan susun ke kanan ni lah eh. Nampak eh? Nampak?
Nampak lah tu.
Okay, jadi ini yang memang dah ada dalam benchmarking awak. Lepas tu baru awak tambah. Bila awak tengok ni, contohnya ada item-item, ada specification yang ada dalam awak punya ni dekat bahagian atas ni. Ada lagi awak punya yang user requirement yang tak cover. Contohnya awak tengok sini. Low noise. Low noise ada tak? Untuk awak measure low noise kat sini. Tak ada eh. Jadi sini awak boleh tambah. Baru awak tambah. Mula awak ambil, awak copy daripada awak punya benchmark. Awak copy sini. Lepas tu awak tambah noise. Noise dia punya tu adalah decibel. Okay, apa lagi yang tak ada sini? Untuk power ada eh. Power absorption, power consumption. Okay, tapi ni power absorption. Dia untuk absorb. Apa tu untuk absorb packaging tu. Kata awak nak pakai ni, awak nak, ni pula lah power consumption pula. Energy. Pun kilowatt juga. Okay, baru awak tambah eh. Lepas tu yang lain lah. Lain-lain. Ni awak dah tambah ni. Okay. Lepas tu yang ketiga. Yang ketiga awak tengok dalam kotak ni pula eh. Dalam kotak ni pula. Satu, dua, tiga, empat. Sorry, yang keempat. Okay. Yang keempat ni adalah interrelation. Relation antara customer requirement dengan technical requirement ni. Okay, jadi awak kena tengok satu-satu. Apa kaitan antara customer requirement ni dengan technical requirement indicator dia ni. Ini indikatornya kosong, no relation. Satu dia boleh buat satu, dua, tiga lah. Senang kan? Satu, dua, tiga. Satu low relation, dua moderate relation dan tiga high relation. Jadi awak kena tengok satu hal ni. Contohnya ni lah, easy to move dengan slide, yes or no? Ada kaitan tak? Ni ada kaitan tak ni?
Ada.
Mana awak nak pastikan produk awak mudah digunakan, patut dia boleh slide lah. Jadi ini kalau ada low relation, moderate atau high relation?
High.
Jadi ni bergantung kepada awak punya judgement. Okay, saya takkan salah awak. Contohnya awak letak satu atau awak letak dua, awak letak awak tiga. Okay, itu no issue. Tapi saya akan tengok lebih kepada macam ni lah. Contohnya sepatutnya easy to move dengan slide yes or no, dia ada kaitan. Tapi awak tak letak, awak biar kosong. Itu saya tolak lah. Maka kalau dalam test saya akan random ni tau. Okay, kalau ni pakai 9, sorry ni pakai 9, kalau 9 awak tak 3. Okay, kalau 1, 3, 9 kan eh, 1, 3, 9, 6.